Rama Rama, Namaste everyone. Welcome you all to session 18 of Samskrita Shri Pathamala 1. Today we will try to revise all that we have learned and also have all your doubts and questions answered. I hope to complete that today and I hope you'll be preparing for your test as well. Let us start with the Mangala Shlokaha. शुक्लां वरधरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः ज्ञानानन्दमयं देवं निर्मलस्फटिकाकृतिम् आधारं सर्वविद्यानां हयग्रीवमुपास्महे सरस्वती नमस्ते स्तु वीणा पुस्तकधारिणी First, we'll start with the sukti for the day. Sukti Kshanashah Kanashah Cha Eva Kanashash Chaiva Vidyam Artham Cha Sadhayet. It means every moment one should learn and bit by bit one should earn wealth. So anything done in small levels, in small bits and consistently over a long period of time pays off good results is what they are trying to say. So don't try to do it all at once. Go step by step, go slowly but steadily is the crux of this good thing that we are seeing today. Now we will do a revision. So we will do the revisions now. Before that, if there are questions, I will. Is it possible to have a few mock tests? The test that we are going to have itself is not a very serious one. It is just for yourselves to gauge your understanding. And this test is, any test is always an opportunity for us to revise whatever we have learned, you know, to firm up the knowledge that we have. And, you know, we're in a way, we are all children. So we always tend to wait for a test to prepare properly. So that is the idea of giving a test. Don't take it very seriously. Enjoy learning this because it's a very beautiful language. You're all here to enjoy learning Sanskritam because this is going to take us to greater heights. We are going to learn very beautiful literature which is given by great poets of our wonderful Bharata Desha. So this is the first step. So please enjoy whatever you're doing. Don't feel stressed. Somebody has asked whether they can take the test at a different time. Yes, the test will be available on the portal just like the previous test is still available. If anybody wants to take that also, they can take it. It will always be available in the course page. So if you're unable to take it at that particular time, you can always try it because this is mainly for your assessment of yourself, nothing else. Okay, now the revision. We started first with the Devanagari script, which has the first part of the Devanagari script was that we saw was Swaras. Swaras are 13 in number. I hope you identify this number as 13, 1 and 3. There are 5 Hraswa Swaraha and 8 Dirgha Swaraha. Vyanjanas or consonants are 33 in number, of which 25 are the Vargiya Vyanjanas or the grouped consonant and 8 of them are Avargiya Vyanjanas. Next, we saw the Ayogavahas. There are 4 Ayogavahas. What are they? Anuswara, Visarga, Jahva, Muliyaha and Upadhmaniyaha. We'll see that again in a bit. Punitaksharani is the thing that we saw next. Punitaksharani are the combinations of consonants with vowels. Consonants, as you know, are not capable of being used independently. So they are to be combined with one of the 13 vowels to be pronounced. The example is kakara with akara gives you ka. So for kakara, the halanta ending is represented by a slanting line below the ka. Next we saw sanyuktaksharas. Sanyuktaksharas are combinations of consonants because successively consonants occur without intervening vowels. An example is shakara with repa gives you this form sh and r, shr. Like the shri, you find this letter shr. So these are the vowels a, e, u, r, l, hrasva, a, e, u, r. Note that this r is written differently. Some textbooks give you this right hand side curve like an R. That is the most common way of writing it. This form is very rarely found. Then A, I, O, Au are all dirghaswaras. There are no hraswa variants of A, I, O and Au. Am and Aha are not swaras. The dot above is anuswara. The two dots on the side is visarga. Then we saw the consonants. Consonants are divided into two parts, the grouped consonants and the which are called the vargiya vyanjanani and the avargiya vyanjanani. Why vargiya? Because all of them are divided into five groups. The first group is the kavarga, or it is called gutturals in English, or kanthya varnaha. Kantha means throat. They are pronounced from the throat. The ka, kha, ga, gha, na. So they are kanthya varnas. Chavarga, cha, cha, ja, jha, nya. These letters are pronounced from the soft palate and so they are called palatals, and they are called talavya varnas in Sanskritam. And tavarga is ta, dha, da, dha, na. They are pronounced by rolling the tongue backwards, and when the tongue touches the hard palate of the mouth, that's when these sounds are produced. So they are called murdhanya varnas. Murdha is the hard palate. Then tavarga, where the tongue touches the teeth. So all of this, the tongue comes in contact with the teeth. Try pronouncing ta, tha, da, dha, na. All five, the tongue will touch the teeth. So they are called dantya varnas in Sanskritam. Pavarga, pa, bha, 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 ma. These only the lips come in contact with each other. These are the oshtya varnas. Oshtha is the lip. So oshtya varnas have the lips coming in contact with each other for pronunciation. Next classification of consonants we saw was the hard consonants, where we stress more, like k, th, ch, ch. Here the stress is more, whereas g, g, ng. Here you don't emphasize or stress that much. So that is the difference between the hard consonants and soft consonants. Which are the hard consonants? The first two varnas of each of the vargas in the vargiya vyanjana category, and the three ushma varnas, which are sh, sh, and sa. These are only the hard consonants or karkasha vyanjanani. The soft consonants are all the remaining consonants, which are the 3, 4, 5 letters of the vargas, and yara, lava, and the hakara, which is the aspirate. And they are called in Sanskritam mridu vyanjanani. Mridu means soft. Then we saw the anunasika varnas are those which are pronounced not only with the respective sthanas. For example, for the kavarga, we saw that throat is the point of origin of the sound of the kavarga letters. But for nakara, in addition to the throat, the nose also plays a role. So it is called anunasika varnas. Nasika means nose. So all the fifth letters of the vargas are called anunasika varnas. Yara, lava together are called antasthaha. They are semi-vowels. Shashra, saha are the sibilants and aspirate together. They are called the ushma varnas, or in plural it is called ushmanaha. Next, we saw the Alpa Prana and Maha Prana letters, the second and fourth letters of the Vargas are Mahaprana letters. Mahaprana means more breath is involved in pronouncing these letters. The difference between ka and kha is you exhale through your mouth to pronounce kha. And similarly, ga and gha, you exhale more air through the mouth to pronounce gha. So the second and fourth, sh, sh, sa, ha of the avargiya vyanjanas, all these put together are called the Mahaprana letters, and the others which are outside the box are the Alpaprana letters. You don't involve, there is no breath involved in pronouncing the other letters. You pronounce them plainly like ka, ga, ga, and so on. Next, the list of Ayogavahas. Anuswara is a dot above any letter. So it always follows the vowel. What you should not get confused is, if I write a makara and write an anuswara on top, or say a kakara and write a anuswara on top, the ka is actually ik plus a. It is a gunitakshara. So finally, the vowel the anuswara follows only the vowel and not the consonant. Anuswara can never be pronounced after a consonant. Similarly, the visarga also cannot be pronounced after a consonant. They are only to be written or pronounced after vowels. So the visarga is the aha kind of sound, like ihi, uhu, etc. It is a ha kind of sound, hakara kind of sound, but the duration is much less. Then the jihva muliya is just half the duration of the visarga itself, because before ka and kha, we reduce the duration and pronounce it as ramah khadati, ramah karoti. Okay, so here we don't say aha fully, ramah, we don't say ramah karoti. Similarly, before pa and ha, ramah pathati, eka saha okay, so the before pa and pa, it is upadhmaniya. Now the gunitakshrani. Gunitakshrani, we have every consonant combining with the 13 vowels to form the gunitaksharas. Because vowel consonants can't be pronounced separately, we saw the different forms. Ka, no change. Ka, vertical line. Ki, a vertical line before with a curve. Ki, a vertical line after with a curve above. Ku, with a curve below the letter. Ku, with a loop and a curve slanting right. Kri, with a small c below the letter. Kri, with an inverted 3 below the letter. L, you just write the L kara below the letter. A is a slanting line above the letter. I is two slanting lines above. O is a vertical line and a slanting line above. Au is a vertical line and two slanting lines above. So we are all very familiar with the gunitaksharas because we've been reading a lot of new words. So there is no difficulty in this part. Then we saw some nouns. We saw a lot of akara words and we saw akara words with ukara, ikara and all the vowels. After that, we saw some grammatical terms. The terms that we came across are swaras. Swaras we already saw. They are a to au. There are haraswa dirgha variants in the vowels, but there are also in usage plutta varnas, which are the elongated forms of the vowels. So these are not represented in the normal varnamala, but you should just be aware of the fact that there is a concept of plutta varnas where the duration is more than 3 matra kalas. It is called a plutta varna. Then we saw vyanjanas. Vyanjanas have a half a matra kala duration for pronunciation. So all the vyanjanas, they don't take much time for pronunciation. Then the Anuswara and Visarga, of course, we saw in detail. Then Sanyuktakshara also, we know what it is. Namapadam. Namapadam is any noun. All the nouns that we learned and all the pronouns that we learned also come under Namapadam. Nama means name. So all everything that has a name is called a Namapadam. Subantam is another name for the Namapadam as well. So basically in Sanskritam, we have Namapadas and Kriyapadas. Kriyapadas are verbs. Next, Sarvanama Padam. Sarvanama Padam is Etat, Saha, Iyam. These are all examples. So what are the Sarvanamas, Shabdas that we learned? Sarvanama Shabdas are Tad, Etad and Idam. Then Kriyapadam. Sarvanama Padam, though it is given a separate name, it comes under Nama Padam only. It is a category or subdivision of the Nama Padam category. Kriyapadam is also called a Tingantam. A thing is added to the Dhatu, so it is called a Tingantapadam. The example is, we have learned so many verbs with different forms in the three Purushas and also the three Vachanas. So an example of a Kriyapadam is Namati, which means it or he or she prays. Visheshanam is an adjective. Adjective is something that describes a noun. Technically, all Visheshanas are also Namapadas. They also come under the category of Namapadas. Then Kriya Visheshanam. So when there is an adverb or something that qualifies or modifies a verb, it is called a Kriya Visheshanam. Kriya is verb. So Kriya Visheshanam is something that gives you more information about the verb. Avyayam is an indeclinable word, which means there are no changes in the form of those words based on the gender or number or the person. Then Bhavarthaka Avyayani. Bhavartham means they are they express an emotion. So Aho is an example. Dhik is an example. These don't undergo number and gender changes. So they are written as such. Aho means alas. Dhik means an expression of contempt or disapproval or disappointment. Dhatu is the basic verb root. To this root only, we add certain endings to form the various Kriyapadani. So the basic root is called the Dhatu. The Lakara is the tense or mode. We may have present, past, different types of past tense, different types of future tense. Similarly, or the mood is also indicated with the use of the Lakara. For example, imperative or optative and so on. Vachanam. There are three Vachanas in Sanskritam. We saw that Eka Vachanam, Dvivachanam and Bahu Vachanam. Purusha is also three. Prathama Purusha or Anya Purusha. In English, Prathama or the first person represents I, we two, we all. Whereas in Sanskritam, I, we two and we all come under Uttama Purusha. And he or they or other nouns that we use comes under Prathama or Anya Purusha. Madhyama Purusha is you, you two and you all. Next, we learned the basic Shabdas. So, Rama Shabda, Rama, Phala are all examples of the basic noun stem. So there is a noun stem to which we add different endings to form the Namapadam. We saw that Namapadam or Subantam is the name given to nouns which are used in a sentence. Now one thing that you should know here is you can never use a Pratipadikam or a Shabda, which is the basic noun stem, as such in a sentence. It has to be made into a Namapadam with the use of endings, proper endings, and then only used in a sentence. So, just like a verb root cannot be used in a sentence, a noun stem can also be used, can also not be used directly in a sentence. Next, Vibhakti. We will see this soon. These are the case endings. For example, for the subject, there is a certain ending. The object gets a different ending. When that noun is being used as a tool, it gets a different ending. These types of modifications to the nouns are called case endings. Don't worry too much about this now. We will see that in detail in the coming classes. Then lingam, pullingam, strilingam, naposakalingam. There are three lingams in Sanskritam. We already saw this. All words in Sanskritam, that is all namapadas, have a lingam. And the lingam of the word in Sanskritam does not depend on the meaning. It depends on the word itself. Many words with the same meaning may have different lingams. That is what is what has been given to us by the sages who have, you know, used the language initially. So they have handed down this information to us, and we are supposed to strictly adopt the same linga distinction for the different nouns. Next, we saw some pronouns. The first is Uttama Purushaha, or first person in English. We know that Asmad Shabda is the only pronoun or only Namapada that can be used in the Prathama Purusha, Uttama Purushaha. Uttama Purushaha is the first person in English. So the Asmad Shabda in all the three lingas has only one particular form for Ekavachanam, which is Aham. It has only one particular form for Dvivachanam, which is Avam. And one particular form of Bahuvachanam, which is Vayam. So, what we say is Trishu Lingeshu Samanaha, which means all the three lingas have the same form, which is Aham in Ekavachanam, Avam in Dvivachanam, and Vayam in Bahuvachanam. Madhyama Purusha, the only pronoun that is used is Yushmat Shabda. That is in fact the only noun that is used, because we saw that Sarvanama Shabda is a subdivision of the Namabada itself. So the forms in the three vachanas are Tvam, Yuvam, Yuyam. Next we saw Tad Shabda for simplicity. In Pullingam it has Saha, Tau and Te for the singular, dual and plural. Strilingam, Sa, Te, Taha, Napunsakalingam, Tat, Te, Tani. Next, we saw the Etat Shabda also. This is again only used in the Prathama Purusha or Anya Purusha. It cannot be in Uttama Purusha or the Madhyama Purusha. Why? Because Uttama Purusha, Madhyama Purusha have only one pronoun each. Uttama Purusha Asmat Shabda, Madhyama Purusha Yushmat Shabda. So this in Pullingam for the three vachanas are Esha, Etau, Ete. Strilingam, Esha, Ete, Etaha, Napunsakalingam, Etat, Ete, Etani. Then, Idam Shabda has Ayam, Imau, Ime in Pullingam, Iyam, Ime, Imaha in Strilingam, Idam, Ime, Imani in Napunsakalingam. Ayam, Imau, Ime, Iyam, Ime, Imaha, Idam, Ime, Imani. So please memorize these forms because it will be useful for you in solving the exercises of the three lessons which are given. Then we saw the question pronoun, which is Kim. Kim Shabda has forms in the three lingams and three vachanam just like any other pronoun. They are Kaha, Kau, Ke in Ekavachanam, Dvivachanam and Bahuvachanam. This is all Pullingam. Strilingam, Ka, Ke, Kaha, Napumsakalingam, Kim, Ke, Kani. There are many similarities between the different Shabdas for the same Linga. Sahatau, Te, Kaha, Kau, Ke. Right? And then, Esha, Etau, Ete. I am, Imau, Ime. So these are all very similar. So you can easily remember these forms by observing the similarities within the gender. Next is the nouns in three genders and three numbers for the Pullinga Rama Shabda. We are seeing now only the Akaranta ending Pullinga and Napumsakalinga Shabdas and Akaranta ending Strilinga Shabdas. So all akara ending shabda. Now Rama is an akara, rasva akara ending shabda. Why? Because it ends in a. So when you add the visarga, you get the ekavachanam form, Ramaha. When you add au, it gets the dvivachanam form, Ramau. Bahuvachanam, Ramaha. So any akara ending pullinga shabda will have only these forms. Ramaha, Ramau, Ramaha. Devaha, Devau, Devaha. Krishnaha, Krishnau, Krishnaha. Similarly, the other akara ending words. Next, Rama. Rama is an akara ending word. The forms in ekavachanam, dvivachanam and bahuvachanam are Rama, Rame, Ramaha. Then Sita, Sita, Sitaha. And so on. Phalam, phale, phalani. For Nabumsakalingam, it is phalam, phale, phalani. Say griham, grihe, grihani. And so on. Then we also saw two other ending shabdas only for Pullingam, which are Hari Shabda and Guru Shabda. Hari is a Hraswa Ikara ending shabda. The first Ekavachana form gets the visarga, so it becomes Harihi, Dvivachanam, Hari, Dirgha Ikara, and Harayaha is the Bahuvachana form. Harihi, Hari, Harayaha. Guru, the Hraswa Ukara ending Shabda. So Ukarantaha. Pullingaha, Guru Shabdaha, it is called, and the forms are Guru, Guru, Guravaha. So Dvivachanam gets a Dirgha. Please notice that. So Guru, Guru, Guravaha. These are the forms. Next, we saw plenty of Avyaya Padas because they are useful for us to construct very interesting sentences. The first one is the conjunction Cha or And. Rama Sita cha dhavatah. Rama and Sita run. Can we have some interaction here? I've been talking for too long now. Anybody who wants to answer can raise your hand. Binaya Kongobi. Binaya Bhagini.
Hello, Ram Ram.
Ram Ram, namaste. So Api means also. I'll give you the sentence as well. Can you tell me the meaning of the sentence?
Yeah. Ramaha Api Patati. Rama yes. Also reads.
Okay. Can you read this and tell me the meaning? Yes.
Param, parantu, kintu, but. Parantu, Krishnaha, likati, but Krishna writes.
Okay.
Prayaha, mostly. Prayaha, chatraha, api, gacchanti. Mostly students also
are going.
Va atava.
Meaning?
Or and or.
It means or. It means both mean or. Yes.
Or. Ramaha Krishnaha va. Agachati. Rama or Krishna is coming.
Yes.
Na. Not.
Yes.
Balaha na kridati. Child is so not.
Sorry, please continue.
Balaha na kridati. Child is not playing.
Okay, so what is the opposite of na?
Pala kridati. The child is playing.
Yes. So when you say no, the opposite is yes. So it is am. Am balaha kridati.
Okay.
Next is.
Okay. Thank you.
I'll give. Thank you. Vidya Subramanyam Mahodaya Bhagini.
Ram Ram.
Ram Ram. Namaste.
Namaste.
So this is a indeclinable. So can you tell me the meaning?
Eva.
Eva.
Only.
That is Eva. Eva is something similar to or like. Like something.
Like something.
Yes. So the sentence here is
Ramaha Chatraha Iva Patati.
Yes.
Rama is reading like a student.
Very good. So Chatraha is a student. Okay.
Eva is only. Ramaha Eva Patati. So good. Only Rama is reading.
Correct.
Punaha. Again. Ramaha Punaha Patati. Rama is reading again.
Very good.
Ataha. Therefore or so.
Yes.
Ramaha Patati. Ataha Saha Nagachati. Rama is studying. So he is not going.
Very good. This is
Yataha because Ramaha na gachati Yataha saha patati. Rama is not going because he is studying.
Good.
Ataha eva. Only for that reason.
Yes.
Ramaha patati ataha eva saha na gachati. Rama is not going out only for the reason that he is reading.
Very good. Uttam. Dhanyavadaha.
Dhanyavadaha.
Vidusanu. Ram Ram, namaste. Yes, we could hear you. Can you unmute yourself and talk? I think it's a problem with your mic.
हेलो
उषा राम
राम उषा
या प्लीज
अत्र अत्र तत्र हियर देयर नारायण अत्र अस्ति तत्र अपि अस्ति नारायण इज हियर आल्सो ही इज देयर सर्वत्र Everywhere. Narayana Sarvatra Astri. Narayana is everywhere.
Uttama. Adaha.
Adaha. Below or down.
Yes.
Phalam Adaha Patati. Fruits are falling. Fruit is falling.
Okay. Good. Upari.
Upari. Upper above. Kagaha upari gachati. Bird is flying.
Bird flying is above. Flying above. Yes. Above.
Pushtataha. Behind. Mama पृष्ठतः गृहम् अस्ति द हाउस इज बिहाइंड मी
यस सो मम इज माय बिहाइंड
माय हाउस इज बिहाइंड मी
बिहाइंड मी यस इट्स नॉट माय हाउस इट्स जस्ट हाउस बट इट इज फॉर पृष्ठतः यू सेड माय बिहाइंड सो बिहाइंड मी इज इन संस्कृत इट्स रिटन एज मम पृष्ठतः गृहम् अस्ति You will learn the usage later. So, what you said is right. Behind me is the house. Purataha.
Purataha. In front of. Mama purataha marga asti. The yes. road is in front of me.
Yes. So, prishthataha and purataha are opposites. Prishthataha is behind. Purataha is front. Adaha and upari are opposites. Below and up. धन्यवादः भगिनी
धन्यवादः
टी एस लक्ष्मी
राम राम
राम राम नेक्स्ट सेट आई विल शो यू
अधुना अधुना इदानीम्
इदानीम्
इदानीम् नाउ नाउ
यस
रामः अधुना और इदानीम् पठति रामः इज रीडिंग नाउ सद्यः सद्यः मीन्स् एट् वन्स् कृष्णः सद्यः वदति कृष्णा विल् टेल् सत्य एट् वन्स् सत्यं
सद्यः इस् एट् वन्स् सो कृष्णः ही गिव्स् अ रिप्लै एट् वन्स् सद्यः वदति
Okay. So, ma'am, could you explain it again, ma'am? At once in the sense?
Immediately.
Okay.
So, without any time gap or immediately is called Satyaha.
Yes.
That Satyam is different. Satyam is the truth. That is different. This is the third Dakara, Yakara followed by the Visarga. Yakara, Nakara followed by Visarga. So, it is Satyaha. There is no visarga there. Yes. So in many times you would have seen in Bhagavad Gita chanting and all, they will say atha prathamodhyayaha. Right? So it means the prathamodhyayaha is going to follow. So it is then.
Tataha. किं भवति देन् किं हू इस् इट्
वाट् हेपन्स् भवति मीन्स् वाट् हेपन्स् नेक्स्ट् वाट् हेपन्स् देन् इस् वाट् वी आर् ट्रैङ्ग् टु आस्क्
वाट् हेपन्स् चिरं चिरम् इत्युक्ते I'm not getting, ma'am.
Chiram is Dirgha Kalam, for a long time.
For a long time.
Yes, for long. So the sentence given is?
Ramaha Chiram Patati. Rama reads for a long time.
Yes.
Tada.
Tada. There is no Mahaprana there, just Tada.
Tada.
Yes. Means at that time.
Not now,
at that time. It can either be the future or the past. So, tada.
Ramaha tada apatat. Rama read at that time.
Yes. Apatat is a past tense form. we are not familiar with it. That's why I marked it in red. But you can just note the meaning is the past tense of is reading. So he read at that time. What we are meaning by this sentence. Next is
Sada Sarvada.
Yes.
Always.
Always.
Ramaha Sada Sarvada Patati. Rama reads always.
Yes. So Tada indicates time. So it gives you the Da ending. Similarly, Sada and Sarvada also have Da ending. So these indicate the time of something taking place. Tada at that time. Sada is always. Sarvada is also always. If you remember the question avyayam that we saw, Kada means when. So that also indicates only time. So Da, you can take it as a hint that it represents time. Okay. Dhanyavadah Bhagini.
Dhanyavadah Bhagini.
उमा देवी भैया
राम राम भगिनी
राम राम नमस्ते
प्रातः मॉर्निंग इन द मॉर्निंग
यस
प्रातः पद्मं विकसति द लोटस ब्लूम्स इन द मॉर्निंग
कैन यू गिव मी अनदर वर्ड फॉर पद्मं
पंकजं Kamalam.
Uttam.
Sayam in the evening. Sayam vayam kridamaha. We play, we all play in the evening.
Excellent.
Sayam prataha, morning and evening.
Correct.
Ramaha sayam prataha. Patati. Rama reads morning and evening. Adhya, today.
There is no Mahaprana there. It is just Adhya.
Okay, Adhya. Adhya, today. Ramaha, Adhya, Patati. Rama is reading today. Shvaha, tomorrow.
Yes.
Shvaha Budavasaraha.
Meaning?
You can say Shvaha Shukravaraha. Shukravasaraha.
Yes.
Yaha yesterday. Yaha. Can I say Yaha Budavasaraha?
Yes. Yaha Budavasaraha. Yesterday was
yes, so Wednesday.
नमस्कार These are the questions.
Kada.
Avyaya padani.
Yeah.
Means?
Kada. When.
When.
Yes. When. So as you said, anything ending with dha is with time. So it and when. Rama.
So in the avyayas that we have seen, the dha endings have a time, indication. So you can't take it as a rule.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying this to give you a hint. Yes. Can you
read
me
so
the
based on that, I'm reading.
Yeah, sure. Kada likhati.
When does Rama write?
Very good. Next is?
Kutra.
Yes.
Where?
Yes.
Ramaha kutra vasati. Where does Rama stay or reside?
Very good. Where does he reside? So here also, datra ending comes in atra, which is here, tatra, which is there, and sarvatra, which is everywhere. So tra indicates place. So this is again a similarity which you can observe. So putra means where.
Katam.
Yes.
How?
Good.
Ramaha katam kridati. How does Rama play?
Excellent.
Kutaha.
Yes.
Why or from where?
Correct.
Krishnaha kutaha agachati. Where does Krishna come from?
The alternative question could be, it could also mean, there are two meanings of kutaha given here.
Why does Krishna come?
Yes, you can. It can either mean why is Krishna coming or where is he coming from. Depending on the context, we have to analyze the meaning. Okay.
How do we assume which is why or from where? What is a leading indicator for that?
In a conversation or when you're reading something, you will always have the context. So based on that, only you can find it. Or if it is in an absolutely unknown context, if there are any bhashyams or any other explanations, you have to refer to that. Otherwise, there is really no way you can find out what is meant by kutaha in that place. So the context is the sole guide. Next is
Kimartha.
Yes.
Why?
Why? Yes.
Kimartham patami.
Vadami.
Vadami. Kimartham vadami.
Yes.
I don't know vadami.
Vadati is. Vad dhatu is to speak.
Okay, vad dhatu.
So,
okay.
The mi ending comes for, when does the mi ending come?
Uttama purushaga.
Correct.
It comes for uttama purushaga, first person.
Very good. First, ekavachana. Uttama purushaha ekavachana is me. So, it always comes with which pronoun?
Okay. This
pronoun is assumed here. Uttama Purusha always has only Uttama one Purusha. Pronoun. Yes.
One pronoun.
Yes.
Aham. Aham.
Exactly. So the singular form is aham.
Aham.
Vadami is also singular.
Aham.
Aham is also singular of the Asmad Shabda. So here, the assumed word is aham kimartham vadami. Why am I speaking?
Okay.
You understand the question? Kimartham is why. Vadami is speaking.
Okay.
So the word that is not given but understood. Aham is understood.
Okay.
Because vadami cannot come with anything else. Is it clear?
Correct.
Yeah. Next is.
So we have. Yeah, so from vadami, you have to infer it is aham kimartham vadami.
Absolutely, correct. Uttamam. Kimiti.
Okay. Kimiti. Kimti.
Kim
kimiti. Is it kimiti?
There are two parts. There are two parts in it. Kim and kimiti. So they are pronounced together. Kimiti is also for what reason? For what?
For what? Okay.
Yes. So you generally say the sentence
gachati.
And then you use kimiti. Yeah, please continue, Mahadev.
Okay. Ramaha gachati kimiti. For what Rama came? What is present tense? So for what Rama comes?
Agachati is to come. Gachati is to go. So Rama goes.
Gachati is goes.
For what?
Sorry, go. Goes.
Yeah. Yes.
Kimiti
is for what?
In this one,
I have a
doubt.
Yes.
In the previous sentence, Kimartham came first and Badami came next.
Yes.
Now we are in this one, Kimiti comes last. So in the question,
that is why I told you.
What should proceed first? Yeah.
So
in English, always the why starts, why, where, how we start the sentence.
Correct. In Sanskritam, in most cases, the order is not important. But here, always Kimiti is something that is used after you have made a particular statement. Whereas Kimartham is used before the verb. Why does this happen? Why is used first? Similarly, Kutaha is also used like Kimartham only. So Kimartham and Kutaha are used interchangeably. Whereas Kimiti is generally used in this style. Ramaha Gachati, Kimiti is what you ask later. Is it clear, Mahadev? It's so just a way of using it.
No, since we are tuned to English way of structuring the sentence, so my mind goes there. First is Kimiti, Ramaha, Gachati.
No, that is why you have to sometimes unlearn what you have, learned in English to learn Sanskritam, because this is a different, completely different style of using different letters. Even though we may find equivalent words in English, the usage may be slightly different, and we have to, with practice and with reading more and more, we have to get used to how a particular word is used as well. So you can observe the difference between Kutaha Kimartham in the first two sentences as against Kimiti in the next sentence. So Kimiti is very, it is not, we don't come across this that often. Even if it does, we use it after a sentence like this. So after you have said what you have to say, then you ask the question why. Is this clear, Mahadev?
Okay. Yeah.
Dhanyavad.
Dhanyavad. Dhanyavad.
Then we saw some more avyaya padas. Somebody can read this as well. Now, I think I'll quickly read this. Pratidinam, aham pratidinam pathami means I read every day. Pratidinam means every day. Prati itself means every. Pratimasaha means every month. So, prati means every. So, when you use it with day, it is pratidinam, is every day. Next, samyak is well or nicely. Saha samyak likhati hirya. He writes well. Samyak. Sometimes we say very good or samyak or well done. Punaha is again. When you use it twice, it means again and again. Aham punaha vadami, aham punaha punaha vadami. I say it again and again. Uchchaihi is loud or high. Chanaihi is softly or slowly. Kathamapi is somehow. And aam is yes. There are some more several more avyaya padas which you will learn later, but for now this should do. Then the lat lakara forms, we have kreed dhatuhu, kreedati, kreedataha, kreedanti. This is prathama purusha. So with saha tau te, sa te taha, tat te tani, all of these anya purusha pronouns, that is sarvanama shabdaha, or with the etat shabda or idam shabda or any noun, you will use the prathama purusha only. So for verbs, we use the order of prathama purusha, madhyama purusha and uttama purusha as a standard. We do not change this order. We do not say kridami, kridavaha, kridamaha first. So when just without these headings, the nine forms are given, you know automatically that the first line represents Prathama Purusha or the Anya Purusha. Second is Madhyama and last is Uttama Purushaha. So Kreedati, Kreedataha, Kreedanti. Kreedasi, Kreedathaha, Kreedatha, Kreedami, Kreedavaha, Kreedamaha. And similarly, the Teetaha, Teetaha, Unti, Seethaha, Tha, and Neevaha, Maha. Endings are added to other verbs to create Kriyapadani for the different verb roots. This is in Lat Lakaraha or the present tense. Then we also saw in the last class the two avyayas va and kim, which are used. Here, kim is not the kim shabda that we learnt. In this place, it represents an avyaya because it is used only to say, to ask a question about the sentence that has just been, or the statement that has just been made. Rama atra pathati. Rama reads here, somebody says. So the other person asks, Rama atra pathati va? Rama, does Rama read here? So for that we use va. We saw earlier that the meaning of va is or, but here it assumes a different meaning. It assumes the meaning of does. So it converts that statement into a question. Again, Krishna tatra kridati. Krishna plays there. When the other person has a doubt about that, he asks, Krishna tatra kridati va kim? Does Krishna play there? So to make the statement into a question, you get the indeclinable form of kim. This also we saw in the last class. So this can also be, the order can also be changed here. Kim Krishna tatra kridati? You can ask the question like this. Whereas for va, we don't do it. We don't put the va in front. Va Ramaha tatra pathati, we don't use it. We use va at the end, and kim can be used in the beginning as well. So the you can try all the homework exercises that were given. And for today, if there are any questions, I will take them and then we can close the session. What does Kim Shabda mean? Kim Shabda means who or what or which. And depending upon the lingam and vachanam, we have to use the appropriate Shabda. For example, for Napumsaka Linga, Bahu Vachanam, we use Kani. Suppose many fruits are falling and you want to ask a question about that, you ask, Kani tatra patanti? You say, Phalani tatra patanti. Okay. There is an exercise 12.3.3 about which some people have a doubt. We will address that now. So you have to transform the following sentences into dual and plural forms, which means the singular form is given. Saha balaha is a singular form. Saha is pullinga ekavachana, is prathama purusha. Balaha is also the same. Pullinga prathama purushaha ekavachana. For this, the dvivachanam will be tau balau. Saha tau te. So we get tau here. Balaha balau balaha. We get balau for dvivachanam. What is the bahuvachanam? Saha tau te. Te is the bahuvachanam of the tat shabda in pullinga. And balaha is the akaranta pullinga bala shabdasya bahuvachanam. So it is balaha. Balaha balau balaha. So you get te balaha. Similarly, for Saha Munihi, what do you do? Saha becomes Tau, just like this. Saha Tau Te. So Tau Munihi, Muni. We saw that Dirgha Ikara is added to make it Vivachana. So it is Muni. Similarly, you have to do the rest. Next, for 3.2, the Dvivachanam is given. You have to make it Ekavachanam and Bahuvachanam. So one vachana is given and you are asked to convert to the other two vachanas. For this, we'll take up etau maybe. So etau gajau. So yeah, you see that it is in dvivachanam. For etau, you know that it is eshaha, etau, ete are the forms. So etau is a pullinga, etad, shabda, and in dvivachanam. For this, the ekavachanam will be eshaha. And for gajau, it will be gajaha. Gajaha, gajau, gajaha. This is the singular form of the ekavachana form. In bahuvachanam, it will be ete, gajaha. Eshaha, etau, ete. So ete is the plural of bahuvachanam. Gajaha is the plural for gaja shabda. So similarly, you do the 12.3.3 where you convert the bahuvachana form to ekavachana dvivachana. So te ashvaha, te here gets a plural meaning because you know that ashvaha is pullingam and sahatau te is plural bahuvachanam. Ashvaha is also plural. So the singular is saha ashvaha, dual is tau ashvau. Like this, you have to do the rest of the things. Any other questions are there? The answers for the questions have already been posted in the course page. There are a lot of icons. There are 3 PDF files of the answers to these exercises. There are 2 audio files of the Shabda and the Dhatu Rupas. So you can download all of them and repeat them and learn the Shabdas and Dhatus. Okay. Lakshmi Raghavan has a doubt. Ram
Ram. Madam, my doubt is in exercise 12.3.12. In that, yeah, 12.3.12. Yeah, ma'am.
That one? This is 8, no?
12.3.12.
I'm not able to see the screen. Oh, this is 11.
Yeah. The next one.
Yes.
Madam, in this 11th, what does the boy do there? The answer was Balaha Tatra Kim Karoti. How is Kim being used there? Kim is for Napum. Acha. But Kim is for Napum Sakalingam, no?
Oh, see, when you don't know what is there, normal thing is to use the Napum Sakalingam. So, Kim is the general questioning word that is used. The Shabda itself is Kim. In Napumsakalinga also it's Kim. And when you're not sure of, for this there is no linga, right? Where the action that he is doing, you don't know the linga yet. So you have to use only Kim here. Tatra Kim Karoti is the normal usage. Yes.
Okay. Madam, how do we arrange the sentences? Like certain cases like, I wrote, why does she come here? I wrote, sa kimartam atra agachati. But it was, the answer was, sa atra kimartam agachati. How do we phrase it, the sentence?
Is there Your sentence is absolutely correct. There is no, I mean, these changes are permissible. It doesn't change the meaning. Sa atra gachati or atra sa gachati, they both mean the same.
Okay. Madam, in ninth, the peacock stands here. It is Mayuraha Atra Tishthati. That is, it is the Murdanya Shakara. Answers.
Yes.
But again, same in 15, the man is standing there for a long time. There it is, the first sha is there. Which is correct? It is the Murdanya Shakara, na?
It is the Murdanya Shakara, which is correct. I will correct it if it is wrong.
Okay. In 19, the girl... The girl also does not eat in the morning. I wrote Bala and the answer is Balika, which is correct, ma'am. Bala can also be written?
Both are correct. Bala and Balika are both correct.
Okay, ma'am.
Dhanyavada.
That's it, ma'am. Dhanyavadaha. Thank you.
Quickly we'll check. More questions. Okay. One more person I can ask. Shriya Badidar. Shriya Bhagini.
Ram Ram.
Ram Ram. Namaste.
Ma'am, I can't able to understand 12.3.3.
Guruhu Vadati is given in singular form, isn't it? Guruhu is Ekavachanam. Vadati also is Prathama Purusha Ekavachanamo Vadadhatu. Is it, do you know that? Have you learned the verb forms for Vadati? Yes. So in Prathama Purusha Ekavachanam, it comes as Vadati. So what is the Dvivachana form? The dual form of Vadati in Prathama Purusha is Vadataha. The first Takara with Akara and Visarga, Vadataha, is the Vivachana form. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So the dual of Guruhu is Guru. I told you the dual gets the Dirgha Ukara. Guru, Guruhu, Guru, Guravaha are the three forms in Ekavachana, Dvivachana and Bahuvachana. So the Dvivachana form of Guruhu, Guru is used and for Vadati, Vadataha is used. So the sentence is Guru Vadataha, which means two Gurus are speaking. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And for plural, what will the plural of Guru, Guru Shabda be? Bahuvachana of Guru Shabda.
Guru Shabda. That is...
Guru, Guru Guravaha.
Guruvaha.
Guravaha. Guravaha Vadanti. Vadati Vadataha Vadanti. Dittaha Nti. For Prathama Purusha, isn't it? So it is Guravaha Vadanti. Gurus are talking.
Yes, ma'am.
Is your doubt clear?
Yes, ma'am. Dhanyavadha.
Dhanyavadha. So we'll close with that. In 12.3.12, which is 12.3.12, there was a word for comes back. It said agachati. Is there a word? Achati is written, is it? I think it should have been a spelling mistake. It should be agachati only. What is the correct form of writing? Pullinga, pumlinga, or pullinga? There can be an anunasika lakara, which means you put a chandrabindhu on the first lakara. That is also a correct form. Or you can write uppu. The combination of pakara and ukara, and on top of that you use an anuswara, that also is a correct form. So pum linga is also right, pul linga is also right. There are two different spellings and pronunciations for that word. Sadhavaha is the plural of sadhuhu. Sadhuhu, sadhu, sadhavaha. It is an ukaranta shabda, so it gets the form like guruhu. Guru Guravaha. So it becomes Sadhu, Sadhu, Sadhavaha. I'm afraid I may not have time for the other questions. We can have another question session on Tuesday. And then in between, if you have some doubts to help you complete the homework, please email me. Try to complete the exercises so that you come ready with your doubts on Thursday and you are also prepared for the test. So now we shall recite the Shanti Mantra and conclude.
Sarve bhavantu sukhinaha. Sarve santu niramayaha, सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत्। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। धन्यवादः। शुभरात्रिः। पुनर्मिलामः।